Hi, everybody. This is John Reed with QualityCoding.org, where I teach iOS developers how to write clean code. Today, I want to talk about refactoring. Refactoring is, I'm afraid, widely misunderstood across our industry. We tell our managers, oh, in order to make this change, I'm first going to have to refactor this. And that means we have a design change in mind. That's good. But the way we do it is we just go and make those changes willy-nilly. That's not refactoring. That's rewriting. Or we say, I can't do the Swift refactoring unless I use Xcode 9, which adds refactoring. No. Xcode 9 adds automated tools for refactoring, which AppCode already has a lot of. And a tool is not the same thing as a discipline. Refactoring is a discipline taught in this important book by Martin Fowler, where you make small, controlled changes, verifying at each step that you have not changed the behavior, and you verify that using unit tests. Let me show you. In my Marvel Browser TDD sample app, I have this struct, the fetch characters Marvel service, which has a method, fetch characters, which calls the Marvel Comics API. And there's this data task, of course. Now, I don't want the service to hold onto the data task as a property. I want that to be managed by a new object, the network request, and I want to pass that in as a new parameter to fetch characters. Now, in the Objective-C version, what I would do is I would come over to the method and either by selecting change signature, command F6, or I prefer control T for everything because I don't have to remember as much. So I control T and say, change the signature and add a new parameter, and then I can add stuff. And whatever I do here changes all the call sites by just throwing in a null argument, which works, of course, in Objective-C. That will not do in Swiftland. What do? The strong temptation is to just go ahead and add the parameter in the function, in the method declaration, and then, of course, that would break all our code, so we go and fix up all the call sites. The problem with that is that this keeps us in a broken state for a long time until we get everything fixed up. Instead, we open this to the inner flap, which has the list of refactorings, a whole bunch of stuff. And we go to the first one, add parameter, look it up. Find it. There it is. It explains everything about add parameter, including a list of steps. And we're just going to follow these steps and list it under mechanics on like that. Okay. Let's follow these steps. First, it says, check to see whether this method signature is implemented by a superclass or a subclass. Well, this is a struct, so no. Next step. Declare a new method with the added parameter. Copy the old body of code over to the new method, and then compile. Let's do that. So here in AppCode, to declare a new method with a new parameter, I'm just going to copy all this. I'm going to command D to duplicate it, and then add my parameter, the network request. It doesn't exist yet, so I option enter. You can also come here and click on this little light bulb thing to say create network request in a new file. As a class, sure, that's fine. There we go. Let me go back. And now we have a new method, and I just want to compile. This is the compile button or command F9. Just to see if it builds. Okay, so I've created a new method with a new parameter and created a stub for this new class. Next, it says, change the body of the old method so that it calls the new one, and then compile and test. Let's do that. So this is going to call the new one, passing in the first parameter, and then let's create a dummy just to do that. And then compile and test. This is very important. I want to make sure that my existing calls to fetch characters, that all those tests are still satisfied. There we go. See, the important thing about this intermediate step is that I haven't changed any of the call sites yet, and I don't have to change them all at once. My tests continue to pass, and we can go one at a time and make sure that each change is correct, rather than being in a state where everything is broken until, you know, how long until it's fixed? I don't know, until I'm done. I could go ahead and commit to trunk and not break anybody. The next step is find all references to the old method and change them to refer to the new one. Compile and test after each change. So one at a time. Let's do this. I'm going to come to the old method, do a context click and find usages. And we see a bunch of stuff in test code and then one stray one in a view controller. Let's add it here. And control R to run my tests. Okay. Now, the panels down here have numbers on them, which show the shortcut. So I can command 3 to go to find and use arrows to navigate around and sort of go around and say, let me command down arrow and jump like that. I could also double click on a particular place to go to that line. And here I want to do the same thing. So I'm refactoring test code right now. And that works. I wonder if we can do them all in one shot, or quite a few of them. And I don't want it in the selection. I can replace all. I can also hold down the Option key, which shows the shortcuts that replace all is Option A. That should take care of quite a few of them. Let's run the tests. All right, how are we doing? Okay, here's another one. We've done several, but there are more here. A handful more. All right. Well, let's do these as well. And Option A for replace all. I think that does them all. Looks like it. I'm going to run my tests and let's have a look. Great. The final steps are to remove the old method so it's no longer there and then compile and test again. But what do you do if there's still a call site that's missing the new parameter? Let me artificially introduce that problem by getting rid of it there. And let's then attempt to continue on with our last refactoring step and say, okay, we can get rid of the old method and run tests, but it fails to build. What I do is I immediately revert. It's like, go back, get out. And then rerun my tests to get back to a green state. Once I'm green, I can fix this last problem, run my tests, and then get rid of the old method and run my tests again. And there we go. We've finished the add parameter refactoring. Finally, what I want to do is move this call to data task resume into the network request inside of a new method. So it's really kind of a combination of extract method and move method. I'm going to deviate from Martin Fowler's book and do it in one step. So what I'm going to do is create a new method here by invoking it. I want it to look like that. Network request, start a data task. It says there is no start method. I can click on the light bulb or I can just option enter to say create the method. It's figured out a name, a nice short name to use. I'm going to go with task and hit enter. And then here it's asking me to confirm the type. It actually doesn't need to be a data task. It can just be a plain Earl session task to be more generic. All right, so there is the stub of the new call. I'm going to Control R to run my tests. Good. Now I'm going to copy and paste this. Actually, let me just cut it. I flip between files using Control Tab, paste that in, and fix up the name. And now let me run my tests. Great. So that's refactoring. Instead of moving stuff around and leaving things in a broken state until the very end, I kept things in a functioning state by moving step by step very carefully. And my tests were green, except where either they actually caught a real mistake or where I demonstrated what would happen if I had made a real mistake. Yay, unit tests coming from TDD. Subscribe to qualitycoding.org for more tips on iOS clean code.